Hi everyone! Welcome to the introductory lesson, which is intended to provide you with an overview of the components of the English end of course exams for English 1 and English 2. This presentation is approximately 5 minutes long. At any point in time, if you feel like you need to review one of the sections, please feel free to stop the video and go back to watch any section over again. At the end of the overview, you will take a quick quiz which will help you to determine if you can move forward or if you need to watch the presentation again. This presentation is an overview of the 4 parts of the English EOC exams. Later, you'll spend more time understanding each of these sections separately. This introduction is just intended to let you see how each of those sections works together to create one final test score. In other words, we want to make sure that every student knows how many different sections are on the test and how much each section affects the final score. So you probably already know that the end of course exam is made up of 2 parts, reading and writing. Each of those parts is weighted the same. The reading portion will be 50% of your final score, and the writing portion will also be 50% of your final score. Let's talk about the reading portion of the test first. The reading portion of the test has 1 section. It's all multiple choice questions. In this section, you will read several passages and answer questions that test your understanding of those passages. The multiple choice section of the reading portion of the test is the most valuable because it's half of the overall EOC exam score. You will answer about 34 questions in the reading multiple choice section. If you look at the writing portion of the test, you will see that it is divided into 3 sections. 2 sections that are multiple choice and cover revision and editing, and 1 section that is an essay. Altogether, you see that there are 4 sections total on the English EOC. The revision section of the writing part of the test is similar to the reading test in that you will be asked to read. But in this section, you will answer a series of multiple choice questions about the reading that ask you to make decisions about revising the text that you have read. These questions, and there are about 9 of them, test your ability to revise writing to make it more effective. The editing section, which consists of about 9 multiple choice questions, tests you on your knowledge of correct grammar, capitalization, punctuation, and spelling. In the writing section, you will have 1 essay to write. For English 1, the essay is expository writing, and for English 2, the essay is persuasive writing. In your test booklet, when you're writing the essay, you will have blank pages that can be used for planning. You can make notes on these pages, you can do some organization of ideas, and you can write a complete rough draft. The more planning and pre-writing you do, the clearer and more complete your essay is likely to be. Okay, so altogether there are 4 sections of the English EOC exam. The multiple choice section of the reading portion of the test is the most valuable because it's half of the overall EOC exam score. It has 34 multiple choice questions for 34 points. The essay writing section is also really important because the essay is a sizable chunk of the writing section. It's almost 25% of the overall EOC exam, and it is worth 16 points. The revising and editing questions, about 18 questions total, 9 per section, are worth 18 points. There are a couple of score situations that you probably want to be aware of. You have seen that the multiple choice portions of the test, the reading, the revising, and the editing portions, are all designed so that each question is equal to 1 point. That's easy to understand and to remember. But let's look at the essay. The highest score you can earn on an essay is a 4. There are 2 people scoring your essay, so you add those 2 scores together. So now the highest score you can earn is an 8. That score is multiplied by 2, and that's where the possible 16 points come from. So you can see that the composition you write here is 2 times more powerful than it seems. You must set a goal of earning between a 2 and a 3 on the essay. If both people reading your essay give it a 2, that would not be considered a passing grade. at least one of the scorers would need to give you a 3. So your writing needs to be between a 2 and a 3 score. Well, I know that's a lot of information. I guess the most important points that we are trying to make here are that the test is divided into 4 separate sections, and that taking the test probably feels like taking 4 mini tests. And then, that each of those 4 sections is not weighted equally. The reading multiple choice is 34, revising is 9, editing is 9, and essay writing is 16. That's a total of 68 points. So when you look at that at a glance, you will see that the reading section and the essay section are the heaviest weighted portions of the test. I hope this information helps you start thinking about your own strengths and weaknesses when it comes to this exam, and I also hope it gives you a starting point for thinking about how to approach the test the next time you take it. Good luck.